India Today World Exclusive visuals coming in from the Hezbollah headquarters in Beirut, Lebanon. The headquarters has been demolished. What remains now is only rubble. This is our exclusive footage that we're playing out for you. Remember, the headquarters had come under attack by Israel airstrikes on Saturday. And that's the image here of Hezbollah headquarters in Beirut, Lebanon, that now is down to rubble. These are targeted strikes that Israel carried out against Hezbollah, particularly targeting the Hezbollah headquarters in Beirut. And here's what it looks like. Exclusive India Today visuals here showing Hezbollah headquarters crushed to the ground in Beirut via Israeli airstrikes. Israel continues to pound parts of Lebanon where they suspect Hezbollah functioning. And this is one of the headquarters, in fact, the main headquarters of Hezbollah in Beirut, Lebanon, that's now been brought to rubble. It's been demolished. What remains is only rubble. Clearly, as we see here, we're looking at Nasrallah, the Hezbollah chief's pictures there planted on the rubble there, the debris that right now lies with the building that's come crashing down. Over that, they put up a flag plus Nasrallah's photograph there on that rubble just to signify or show the solidarity. Lebanon civilians there showing solidarity to Hezbollah chief Nasrallah, who was killed in this targeted strike from and through Israeli air missiles that's been targeting Lebanon through the course of last few weeks. And this is that very building, the Hezbollah headquarters, that was under target and that's come now crashing down. This is the first image that we're bringing for you right here on India Today.
I'm currently standing and I'm the first international journalist from India Today who is at the Hezbollah headquarters here in South Beirut. Behind me you can see this was the six-story building when Saeed Hassan Nasrallah, the Secretary General of Hezbollah, was taking a meeting of his commanders in the basement. It was underground, almost 15 feet below the ground, where he was taking that meeting. 2,000 pounds of bombs dropped on this building by the F-15 warplanes, which completely brought this building on ground. And after the efforts for 4 days, finally the body of take some details from here of the people of leaders really happened here, and what happened after this blast, and what was its impact not only here and but also in the periphery. In fact, since then there is regular airstrikes in this area, suburbs of Beirut, and today on Wednesday, 7 airstrikes were carried out by the IDF. Yesterday, a television station was targeted, its building was, compound was targeted, that collapsed in that attack, and today a communication tower has been targeted in this area, and we are facing the internet problems in this particular area here in the Beirut. Ashrapani, for this World Expo, India Today.
I'm currently standing and I'm the first international journalist from India Today who is at the Hezbollah headquarters here in South Beirut. Behind me you can see this was a six-story building when Saeed Hassan Nasrallah, the Secretary General of Hezbollah, was taking a meeting of his commanders in the basement. It was underground, almost 15 feet below the ground, where he was taking that meeting. 2,000 pounds of bombs dropped on this building by the F-15 warplanes, which completely brought this building on ground. And after the efforts for 4 days, finally the body of
Hezbollah.
And we'd like to take some details from here of the Hezbollah leaders were really happy there, and what happened after this last and what was its impact not only here and but also in the periphery. In fact, since then there is regular airstrikes in this area suburbs of Beirut, and today on Wednesday 7 airstrikes were carried out by the IDF. Yesterday a television station was targeted, its building was compound was targeted that collapsed in that attack, and today the communication tower has been targeted in this area, and we are facing the internet problems in this particular area here in the region. Ashrapani for this World Expo for India today. Standing and I am the first international journalist from India today who is at the Hezbollah headquarters here in South Beirut. Behind me you can see this was the 6-story building when Saeed Hassan Nasrallah, the Secretary General of Hezbollah, was taking a meeting of his commanders in the basement, which was underground almost 15 feet below the ground, where he was taking that meeting. 2,000 pounds of bombs dropped on this building by the F-15 warplanes, which completely brought this building on ground. And after the efforts for 4 days, finally the body of and we would like to take some details from here of the people of leaders that were really happy there, and what happened after this last and what was its impact not only here and but also in the periphery. In fact, since then there is regular airstrikes in this area suburbs of Beirut, and today on Wednesday 7 airstrikes were carried out by the IDF. Yesterday a television station was targeted, its building was compound was targeted that collapsed in that attack, and today the communication tower has been targeted in this area, and we are facing the internet problems in this particular area here in the region. Ashrapani for this World Expo India today.
All right, well, that's what we see of the Hezbollah headquarters in Lebanon that's literally crushed to the ground. This has happened a few days ago. Images here, first on India Today with Ashraf, our correspondent, who's right at the epicenter to give you those clear visuals up close. You see how Nasrallah, Hezbollah chief's photograph, has been placed on that rubble there with flags. This is in a way to show solidarity to the Hezbollah chief. We see civilians gathering right around the Hezbollah headquarters, placing a photograph of him who was killed. He himself was killed recently. We're seeing the headquarters being bombarded and crushed down to the ground. These are the images of the Hezbollah quarters confirming how Israel is carrying out targeted strikes on Hezbollah establishments. This was one of their main targets, the Hezbollah headquarters in Beirut. This is exactly where Nasrallah, Hezbollah chief, was functioning, and this is now what it looks like, the entire building come down to rubble, with photographs of the late Hezbollah chief Nasrallah, who was killed in these strikes, placed on that rubble. Let me cut across to Ashraf Vani, who's the first to bring us these images right here on India Today.
I'm currently standing and I'm the first international journalist from India Today who is at the Hezbollah headquarters here in South Beirut. Behind me you can see this was the 6-story building when Saeed Hassan Nasrallah, the Secretary General of Hezbollah, was taking a meeting of his commanders in the basement, which was underground almost 15 feet below the ground, where he was taking that meeting. 2,000 pounds of bombs dropped on this building by the F-15 warplanes, which completely brought this building on ground. And after the efforts for 4 days, finally the
body of and we would like to take some details from here of the people of leaders what really happened here and what happened after this last time, what was its impact not only here and but also in the periphery. In fact, since then there is regular airstrikes in this area suburbs of Meru, and today on Wednesday 7 airstrikes were carried out by the IDF. Yesterday a television station was targeted, its building was compound was targeted, that collapsed in that attack, and today the communication tower has been targeted in this area, and we are facing the internet problems in this particular area here in the Meru. Ashraf Ani for this World Expo, India today. I'm currently standing and I'm the first international journalist from India Today who is at the Hezbollah headquarters here in South Korea. Behind me you can see, this was the sixth story building when Saif Hassan Nasrullah, the Secretary General of Hezbollah, was taking a meeting of his commanders in the basement, which was underground almost 15 feet below the ground, where he was taking that meeting. 2,000 pounds of bombs dropped on this building by the F-15 warplanes, which completely brought this building on ground. And after the efforts for 4 days, finally the body of and we would like to take some details from here of the people of leaders, what really happened here and what happened after this last time, what was its impact not only here and but also in the periphery. In fact, since then there is regular airstrikes in this area suburbs of Meru, and today on Wednesday 7 airstrikes were carried out by the IDF. Yesterday a television station was targeted, its building was compound was targeted, that collapsed in that attack, and today the communication tower has been targeted in this area, and we are facing the internet problems in this particular area here in the Meru. Ashraf Ani for this World Expo, India Today. I'm currently standing and I'm the first international journalist from India Today who is at the Hezbollah headquarters here in South Korea. Behind me you can see, this was the sixth story building when Saif Hassan Nasrullah, the Secretary General of Hezbollah, was taking a meeting of his commanders in the basement, which was underground almost 15 feet below the ground, where he was taking that meeting. 2,000 pounds of bombs dropped on this building by the F-15 warplanes, which completely brought this building on ground. And after the efforts for 4 days, finally the body of and we would like to take some details from here of the people of leaders, what really happened here and what happened after this last time, what was its impact not only here and but also in the periphery. In fact, since then there is regular airstrikes in this area suburbs of Meru, and today on Wednesday 7 airstrikes were carried out by the IDF. Yesterday a television station was targeted, its building was compound was targeted, that collapsed in that attack, and today the communication tower has been targeted in this area, and we are facing the internet problems in this particular area here in the Meru. Ashraf Ani for this World Expo, India Today.
And that's our correspondent Ashraf right on the ground at the epicenter where Hezbollah headquarters has been crushed to the ground. This is Lebanon. And mind you, Israel has not stopped its pounding on parts of Lebanon where Hezbollah still is functional. Pounding continues even till today. Multiple targets were struck, and in total, nearly 55 people have died in the latest number that we have here from Lebanon. Many of them civilians who've also succumbed in this. But that image there was of the Hezbollah headquarters that shows how it was brought down to rubble, with civilians paying solidarity, showing their respect, placing Nasrallah, the Hezbollah chief's photograph, right on that rubble for a reason, to basically grieve his death. We know that Israel at this point is fighting a multi-pronged war, multiple sides that they are facing heat from. The latest, Iran has fired multiple missiles there, nearly 180 to be precise. And while they're battling Iran's onslaught, they continue pounding Lebanon. We're looking at Israel right now in the center here. Emily Botball, who's a journalist, joining us live from Israel's Tel Aviv to give us a little more on that. Emily, we're looking at Israel, who's fighting a multi-pronged war. We see that just last night, after Iran fired multiple missiles, they asked their citizens to take shelter, ensure they don't step out. But this morning, we hear the situation was entirely different. The Israel establishment has allowed for people to step out, saying that they are free to move around. Situation is safe. Why don't you give us a quick roundup on what the mood sentiment largely on the ground is, while tensions prevail all around you?
Absolutely. Reporting here from Tel Aviv, Israel, where last night, as you very well said, Iran launched a massive ballistic missile attack. Over 180 ballistic missiles at Israel, sending millions of Israelis to bomb shelters for nearly an hour. Now, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has said that Iran has made a big mistake and will pay for it. The United States has led a coalition that helped Israeli Air Force thwart most of the ballistic missiles aimed at Israel. In terms of retaliation, we have received reports that retaliation in the coming days could take the form of a direct hit on Iran proper, on oil production facilities and strategic sites in Iran, as well as potentially targeted assassination, much like the assassination of Hezbollah's chief Hassan Nasrallah last Friday, an assassination of many leaders and many members of Hezbollah's leadership. Now, this morning, as Israel prepared to celebrate the holiday of Rosh Hashanah, which is the Jewish New Year, Israelis are reuniting with families. They are traveling all over the country to join their loved ones, despite the fact that last night, two terrorists onboarded the Tel Aviv's light rail and attacked passengers on the light rail before stepping out of the train and shooting and stabbing at passersby on Sderot Yerushalayim in Tel Aviv, Yafo. Now, we have received reports of seven murdered, as it is, and several injured. We are only now getting the identity of the victims. As for the two terrorists, one of them has been fully neutralized and killed. The second one has been critically wounded. We are still waiting to receive more information as for Israel's retaliation with regards to Iran. As you know, we are preparing, as we enter the period of the high holidays, to mark 1 year since Hamas's October 7 massacre of 1,200. Since then, Hezbollah, as you mentioned, has been sending nearly or over 10,000 missiles, drones, and rockets towards northern communities. Only today, this morning, dozens of Israeli communities have been targeted by rockets all morning.
We have some of the visuals there. I'd like you to stay with us, Emily. We have some of the visuals there that substantiates what you say. Iran launching nearly 200 missiles directly at Israel. We know that this has come in response to Israel killing the Hamas chief as well as Hezbollah chief. This is in response. Iranian media releases this footage on Tuesday, which shows how they've bombarded parts of Israel through their air missiles. Iran fired ballistic missiles in retaliation for Israel's campaign against Tehran's Hezbollah allies in Lebanon, drawing sharp reactions. In fact, as we see, 180 precisely, the missiles, number of missiles used, 180 of them that targeted parts of Israel, many of them were intercepted thanks to the Iron Dome. Viral footage on social media showing few missiles hitting the ground at Nevatim, Hatzairim, and Tel Nof. These are the three air bases in Israel that were targeted. Iranian attack reportedly destroyed a number of F-35 stealth fighter jets in Nevatim air base and F-15s in another air base that was stationed. In fact, these warplanes are extensively used by Israel to bombard Lebanon. The Israeli army has been carrying out secretive ground operations to destroy Hezbollah's infrastructure in Lebanese villages close to the border for the past year. Military releases a footage of what it says where Israeli soldiers uncovering tunnels and weapons in at least three of the Lebanese villages. Rockets flew over the Jordanian skies as Iran fired a salvo of ballistic missiles at Israel on Tuesday in retaliation for Israel's campaign against Tehran's Hezbollah allies in Lebanon. Alarms have sounded across Israel. Explosions could be heard in Jerusalem and the Jordan River Valley after Israelis piled into bomb shelters. Allahu Akbar! Rockets lit up the skies over Jerusalem on Tuesday after Iran fired salvos of ballistic missiles at Israel. In fact, Israeli army radio said nearly 200 missiles have been launched into Israel from Iran. Initially, civilians in Israel rushed to bomb shelters and were staying indoors. Now they've been told they are free to move around. Situation is safe.